Ever wondered if hypnosis is real or just a bunch of mumbo jumbo? Well, I've got some answers for you. Hi, I'm Dr. Wendy Walsh for Local Now. I actually am a professor of both health psychology and developmental psychology at California State University, Channel Islands. And in my health psychology class, we talk about hypnosis as a treatment. Did you know the very beginning of psychology and psychotherapy was actually done by a stage performer called Mesmer? Franz Mesmer in the 1700s mesmerized entire audiences by holding magnets over their bodies because he felt that everybody has magnetic energy. And through the power of suggestion, he asked them to do things that would heal themselves. He actually was a doctor as well. This was the beginning of understanding that we have unconscious processes as well as conscious processes. And his work actually evolved today into what we now know as modern day hypnotherapy. So, does hypnosis actually work, and what is it? Hypnosis is kind of an altered state of our mind where either looking at an object or being instructed through the power of suggestion to relax our body and our mind, people can go into a deep state of relaxation, almost like the state in between waking and sleeping. And while in this state, some suggestions are made to them that can sink deeper into their unconscious. The biggest myth about hypnotherapy or hypnosis is that someone can take over your brain and make you do something you don't want to do. That's entirely untrue. Nobody will ever do something under hypnosis that they wouldn't do in real life. And only about 80% of the population can actually become hypnotized. That's because 20% are highly skeptical and don't believe in it. You see, you have the power of your own mind. Okay. So if it's just going into a deep state of almost sleep and you have somebody making suggestions, how does it actually change behavior? Well, it does. In fact, research shows that hypnosis can help for all kinds of negative behaviors like smoking and overeating. It can also reduce anxiety and depression, and it's also a proven good treatment for post-traumatic stress disorder. The most important thing, though, is that a patient wants to be hypnotized and is open to it. And while they're in that altered state, that they're open to the power of suggestion to be a better person, to have better behaviors. People who tend to get the most benefit from hypnosis tend to be people who are open to new experiences, people who are able to focus and tune out a lot of peripheral sensations, and people who believe that it can really work and help them. It's more than just the power of suggestion. It's trust that your own body and mind can make the changes that it needs to be a better person. Thanks for watching. I'm Dr. Wendy Walsh for Local Now. You can follow me on my social media @Dr. Wendy Walsh. We'll see you next time.